Hi, I'm Jane from Poppy Patchwork, and welcome to my quilt block series. In each of these videos, I'm going to show you how to make a different block, and they're all going to measure 12 inches. I hope you like this video. If you do, click the like button, and please let me know in the comment section below what other videos you'd like me to make. Let's get quilting. This is my quilt block notebook, and it's available on Amazon. The links are in the comment section below. And if you click on the link above, it'll take you to my video all about it. Today, I'm going to show you how to make the Blackford Beauty block, and this will make a 12-inch block. And if you'd like to know how to use this block in a quilt, please watch to the end of this video where I've got some illustrations to show you how to use it. You will need 1 4¾-inch square in background fabric, 8 2-inch squares in background fabric, 8 2 by 3½-inch strips in background fabric. In fabric A, you will need 1 3½-inch square. And in fabrics A1, 2 and 3, you will need 4 2-inch squares in each. In fabric B, you will need 4 2¾-inch squares. In fabric C, you will need 1 4¾-inch square. 4 2¾-inch squares and 4 2¾-inch strips. Making the flying geese using the 4-at-a-time method. For flying geese A, use the 4¾-inch square in background fabric and the 2¾-inch squares in fabric C. For flying geese B, use the 4¾-inch square in fabric C and the 2¾-inch squares in fabric B. Draw a diagonal line on the wrong side of the small squares. As shown here. Repeat on all 8 squares. Place the small squares in opposite corners of the large square, right sides together with the drawn lines as shown. Then pin in place. Repeat for both flying geese A and B. Sew 1/4-inch away from the drawn line on both sides of the line, as shown. Cut in half across the diagonal along the drawn line. As shown here. Press seams towards the small triangles. Repeat as shown. Place a small square in the corner of the unit as shown. Pin in place and sew 1/4-inch seam away from the drawn line on both sides of the line. As shown here. Cut in half across the diagonal along the drawn line. As shown. And press seams towards the small triangles. Repeat with all 8 units. trimming the flying geese with a speciality ruler. I use the Ultimate Flying Geese tool by Deb Heatherly from Creative Grids. Lay the unit under the ruler for trim number one at the 1.5 by 3 inch mark on the ruler. Trim along the right and top sides of the ruler as shown. Rotate the ruler and the unit round to trim number two, line up to 1.5 by 3 inches. Trim along the right and top sides of the ruler as shown. Trim all 8 units. If you do not have a speciality ruler, then click on the link above to take you to my video on how to trim your flying geese with a standard quilting ruler. And when doing this, trim these units to 2 by 3.5 inches. Make the flying geese sections. Lay out the flying geese as shown on this diagram. Pin the top units together and sew with a 1/4 inch seam. As shown here. Then pin the bottom units and sew with a 1/4 inch seam. Then press towards the center strip. Making the corner sections. Lay the pieces as shown. Lay pieces as shown, 2 in layout A and 2 in layout B. Sew together with a 1/4 inch seam, as shown here. Repeat to make 4 corner sections. Block layout. Place the units in block design. Pin the bottom row units together and sew with a 1/4 inch seam. Return to the block layout. Pin the top row units together and sew with a 1/4 inch seam. Press the seams in the direction shown. Pin the right column to the center column and sew with a 1/4 inch seam. Return to the block layout. There's no need to press yet. Pin the left column to the center column and sew with a 1/4 inch seam. Return to the block layout and press the seams open. Congratulations, you have made the Blackford Beauty Quilt Block. Here are some quilt options. This is an illustration of the quilt repeating the same block. There is no sashing or borders, but the use of the white background fabric in the block allows the design and fabrics to stand out. This is an illustration of the quilt repeating the same block placed on point. There is no sashing or borders, but you would need to add blocks in background fabric in between the blocks, shown here with the stars. And use setting triangles around the edges, again shown here with the stars. This is an illustration of the quilt repeating the same block but with sashing, cornerstones and borders. And finally, this is an illustration of a sampler quilt using some of the blocks from this quilt block series. The sashing in this quilt is in the white background fabric. The cornerstones and border is in a darker fabric to pop and frame the quilt. Want to learn more? Watch another one of my videos from the Quilt Block series. Click above to go to my playlist. I hope you liked this video. Please like and subscribe to my channel. More of these videos will be posted, so please tune in. Thank you for watching and bye for now.